Hello, my data science friends. Hope you are having a wonderful day. I'm Divyansh Agrawal and you're watching Knowledge Overflow. Today we will be talking about another data science course that is coming your way from Carleton University in Canada. So in this video, we will be talking about the course overview, the program curriculum, the requirements, international requirements, how to apply, fees, scholarships, everything. So stay tuned to the last of this video to know everything about this course. And if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel and share this channel and the video with your friends who are looking out for data science courses. So you need to stick to the video to the last because this is going to be a long one because there is a lot to tell in this course. It is a very complicated one. So let's just move further with the university profile. So this university is situated in Ottawa, Canada, the capital city, and they've got a world rank of 601 to 650 rank band. Status is public, research output is very high. Student to faculty ratio is all right, 28 is to 1. Scholarships are there, yes, I will be telling about that in a while. International students are already above 5,000, size is large. So, if you talk about the rankings by subject, so this course is offered by the Department of Computer Science here. And for computer science, they have got a world rank in the rank band of 301 and 350. And also, world employability ranking, they have got a rank in the rank band of 300 to 500. So this is also very good, and you can look this university for sure. Now, let's just circle back to the course. This is the course that goes by the name of Masters of Computer Science, but they have a specialization called Collaborative Specialization in Data Science. So this is a course in data science in that way. You have to have a specialization in order to complete this computer science course. So you will be going for the Collaborative Specialization in Data Science. What degree you will be getting is Master of Computer Science. Co-op option is there, so this is a very interesting option. And the length of this program is 2 years full time. The entry are both for the fall and winter term, so this is one good thing about this course. So the application deadline for fall semester is January 15th and it is September 15th for winter. And you can go apply for it for the fall semester, fall 2022. January 15th is the deadline. And this degree is offered by the Ottawa Carleton Institute for Computer Science, OCICS. Remember, in University of Ottawa, there was another course. There is a video on that as well. You can have a look. This is one such course that is offered by that as well. So, along with the School of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science at the University of Ottawa. And these are the sites you can have a look. I mean, this is a whole research-based course. It is not a project-based course, so you will be writing a thesis for this. So the final year would totally be a thesis. So you will be giving 12 complete months to writing a thesis. Now, if you talk about the data science specialization, they have already said that there is no standalone course for data science in Carleton, but this is offered as a specialization in many courses. One such course is Master in Computer Science. The data science specialization can be taken with other courses as well. And for the admission, you must apply for the Master in Computer Science. And also, there is a preference form where you have to fill in the data science specialization in that. I will be telling about the preference form in a while. And if we just talk about the course curriculum, so this is the course curriculum, a bit short, but that is all they have in the 2 years of your study. In the first year, you will be studying Data 5000. That is the data science seminar. And there are some other courses in the first year itself. So there will be 2 credit. Coursework is required, and there are a lot of buckets from which you have to choose. So these coursework must include a minimum of 1.5 credits of OCICS courses in at least 3 different research areas. So I'll just be scrolling down and you will see the research areas, 3 different research areas, and 2.5 credits are the final MCS thesis. So this is the thesis you will be writing for a complete whole year. Now let's just scroll a little and see what are the research areas and what are the courses that you can get into. So these are the graduate courses. So software engineering is one such specialization, not specialization, research area. So one is software engineering, another one is theory of computing, another one is computer applications, and finally there is computer systems. So you will have to select at least 3 courses out of all these long list of courses. You can have a look. I will just pause it for a while at every section, and you can have a look, maybe take a screenshot as well for all these courses, and then you can have a look of what are the courses that you're gonna study here. So these are the courses, and this was all about the course curriculum. Now if you talk about the admissions, so admissions to MCS in data science, what you have to do is to you need to have a bachelor's degree, of course, in computer science or equivalent. Mathematics and statistics also can be included in that. And You need to have a degree where you have at least 12 computer science half credit courses. Half credit means, according to them, so 0.5 credit courses. And 8 half credit courses are required in mathematics. So there is a rigorous requirement of mathematics as well. Apart from that, if you have a 3-year bachelor's degree, don't need to worry. You might be admitted to a qualifying year program. So suppose you have a very stellar profile. If you have a BSc or maybe other degree related to this particular field, they will be able to offer you an admission. But prior to that, you will have to undergo a qualifying year program. Now, what is a qualifying year program? It is basically something which is required by the people who are provisionally admitted to a particular course program, but because of a lack of certain courses that they haven't covered in their bachelor's degree, they will have to cover all those courses before the start of their master's program. So this is called the qualifying year program. Now, if you talk about the English requirements, so English requirements are really strict here. If your first language is not English, you will have to give a ESL score. And otherwise, if you are from a country where primary language is English, like Canada, United States, United Kingdom, or any other country. But here in India, it is not the case. In India, English is not considered a primary language, so you will not be able to get through it. You will have to appear for an English language test. And also, they have explicitly written that letters from your university stating the medium of instruction is English are not acceptable. So they take 4 tests. One is the CAEL. The score required is 70. TOEFL IBT, they require 86 with second cutoffs 20 in reading and listening and 22 in speaking and writing. And they also accept IELTS Academic, of course. 6.5 is the minimum requirement with 6 in each band. And Pearson test is also taken with 60 overall and 60 in each communicative skill section. These are the English language requirements that you have to follow. And now you have made up your mind to apply. So how you can apply online? So they have their own portal called Carleton Central, where you will have to make your account and then you will have to apply. So how you can do that is, first of all, you have to prepare some documents, of course. So these documents are transcripts, referee contact information, statement of intent, CV, resume, writing sample, and language proficiency test. So these are the requirements. And once you have collected all these documents, all you have to do is to just apply. You will have to make a Carleton 360 account. And what you have to do is to select your program. You already know you will be applying for MCS Data Science. Term of application, which term, like fall or winter. So you will be going for fall if you are applying now. And as you move along the online application, you will be required to enter details about your academic history, referee information, English language score if applicable, of course, in our case, if you are from India. And once all these things are done and the documents are uploaded, what you have to do is to pay an application fees of 110 Canadian dollars, which, if we convert to Indian rupees as of the current rate, it will turn out to be around 6,500 Indian rupees. And now you have applied. Now, how you can check the application status? You can obviously log into the Carleton Central and then you can find out the status of your application in the graduate admissions section. And deadlines, I have already told you, 15 January is for fall 2022. This remains the same throughout every year. And the documents I already told you, the review of applications. So you may get the decision on a rolling basis, or you may get the decision after the application deadline. So they haven't made clear as to what is the policy of them to review the application. You might receive your offer on a rolling basis, or you might receive a decision after the application deadline ends. And there are some questions that I wanted to tell you about applying online. And before that, yeah, these are the documents that I told you about. The preference form specifically for data science courses, that was a generic apply online thing. So for this particular course, what you have to do is to find the preference form that I told you about, statement of interest, CV or resume, 2 letters of reference, and it is recommended that at least one recommendation letter is from professor. And if you can find both of them from the professor, that is well and good. And finally, the transcripts of all your post-secondary studies. So after 12, whatever you have studied, you need the transcripts for that. And these are the frequently asked questions that I wanted to share. So what is the preference form in MCS application and how do I complete it? So this is a form where you will be filling some details like thesis or project option. Since here it is not a project one, so this is only a thesis option. Your preferred research area, you will be telling about your research area and potential faculty supervisors. Yes, you will have to find potential supervisors for for you. Any funding required to support your studies, like suppose you have got any scholarship external before you apply here or something like that. Name of the institution and degree most relevant to MCS program that you have completed. The six courses that you have taken that are most relevant to MCS program and publications. Of course, these are the things that will make up your application more clearer. And here you will also be explaining about your data science specialization. Here, when you open this form, you will be having this option to go for a specialization. Here you can express your interest, data science specialization. And what should I include when writing my statement of intent? These are the questions that most of the people come about. They are always confused. So they have given that please include why you want to pursue graduate studies in computer science, especially at Carleton, and what are your research interests, short and long-term objectives, and why are you applying for this particular university, especially to Department of Computer Science, and why do you think you have a sufficient background to pursue research interests? So these are the kind of things that you might need to write in the statement of intent. You can find it. And yes, you need a faculty supervisor before you apply, but that is not necessary. I mean, you will be entering a common pool where your application will be shared to other professors, and if they find a fit with them, you will be entering the university. So it is advisable to find a potential supervisor way before time. And another thing was what kind of funding is offered for the MCS and PhD programs. So for this particular program, funding is offered in terms of TARA and departmental scholarships and entrance scholarships all at the time of the admission. And another question that I found very interesting was they have clearly spelled out the statistics of their admission intake. So for fall admission in masters in computer science for 3 years, 16, 17, and 18, they have given the data. So you can see, like in 2018, 974 international applicants were there, and 36 were made offer to. And in contrast, there were only 46 domestic applicants and 20 were given the admission. So we can see the kind of competition, but you don't need to fear from that. And apart from that, I would like to share this page with you guys. I will put this link into the video description. This is the International Student Service Office. And this is basically a one-stop shop for all the international students. If you have any query regarding living in Canada or at campus or anything related to your life as an international student in Canada and most particularly in Carleton University, this is the place for you guys. You can explore this page and just have a look and ask questions and all. Now, if you talk about the fees, the main thing, the main most important thing of this particular program. So, to save time, these were the drop downs, and I have made the selections on all the drop downs to save time. So, our graduate program is this. So, first year, and it's a full-time course. So, in the first year, we'll be studying five courses, and residency status is international for us, of course. Program is Master of Computer Science. UPAS fees I have included, and University Health Insurance Plan I have included. So, if I estimate the fees, it would turn out to be $10,545 for the first year. And same goes for the second year as well. So, it doesn't depend on number of courses, at least in graduate courses, as what I can see. And even if I just turn it into the final year, into the second year, it will just come out to be the exact same amount. So for 2 years, your total fees would be 21,090 Canadian dollars. And if we convert it into Indian rupees, it would correspond to around 12,42,000 Indian rupees. So that's the amount that we are talking about for 2 years to spend here in Carleton University. If you still feel there is a burden on you with this fees, you can have a look at the scholarships as well. There are numerous scholarships. I've already told you about four kind of them, TARAs and entrance and dean scholarships and all. And apart from that, there are some internal awards as well. These are the internal awards that you can have a look at. Donor funded awards, graduate student travel research bursary, indigenous graduate student award. This might not be for the international student. James Travers Fellowship, grants from the Center of Research, and Richard J. Van Loon Scholarship. So these are the kind of scholarships. I will not go into the details of it. I'll just share this link and you can have a read on that. Apart from that, there are some external scholarships as well. You can see here as well. This is the page, and you can explore this as well. Apart from that, there are special awards as well. So there are a lot of scholarships, and I started giving explanation of each and every scholarship. It would have been maybe a 1 hour video, so I'm not getting into that. I'll pass all the three links into the video. And finally, we come down to the co-op option. So this is one such course that you can pursue with a co-op option as well. So suppose you are writing a thesis in the last 12 months of your study, you can also avail a co-op option if you feel like you will be able to manage the research and internship both. And for co-op program, of course, most of you must already be aware about it. But if you are not aware about what a co-op program is, it is a program, cooperative program, where you study and you get a chance to work in industry in your own field as an internship, and it might also serve as a PPO for you guys. So this is one very good thing that Canadian universities offer, co-op program. And to apply to co-op, first of all, you need to have an offer letter from the university itself. Once you have the offer letter from the Carleton University, then only you will be able to apply to the co-op program. If you want to apply to the co-op, you need to apply at the end of the first term and have a minimum of A negative in the last two courses at the computer 5K levels. They must have also completed four graduate courses and have a minimum of A negative in each of these courses. So that was all about this particular course. I hope you like this video. I hope you got a clearer idea about how this course is structured and how you can get with a data science specialization in this course, how you can integrate your co-op as well with your research thesis. And if you like the video, if you like the content, please subscribe to the channel and show your support that you do acknowledge my hard work, and that will really push me to keep moving forward with other data science courses and rather other domain courses as well in the near future. I'll try to expand my channel as much as I can with more courses in other domains like general computer science programs, cybersecurity programs, and all these kind of things in the near future. So please stay tuned to the channel and ask your friends and invite your friends to this channel to explore this gold mine. So in the next video, I'll meet you with another data science course. I'll be telling about some interesting data science course and how to apply and all these things. Until next video, au revoir.